I can't believe we're doing this again, but let's do another tutorial. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is JC, this is Jeepers JC, and we are going to do an infamous makeup tutorial today, which is a pumpkin face. So I am not gonna do a huge intro. Let's just get started. I have done something very similar to this in the past. As you can see here, let's get started. I never used to be a huge headband girl, until I saw these at an apple butter festival in Grand Rapids. And they were like 4 for $20, all like local handmade stuff. I do have another one up here. Got a Louis one too, but they all have knots in the top. I used to hate my forehead. Now that I'm old, I don't care. Let's just keep it out of her face, eh? Trusty Johnson. I'm really gonna lather it on this time, just because a majority of my face will be covered in the Spirit Halloween cream makeup. And I want to try to limit the cracks in the cream makeup as much as possible. I'm going to start by just roughly outlining everything that will be orange. This pencil was a little bit too sharp. Okay, so there's that outline. And then I'm just gonna go in. Let's put this on a sponge first. Oh, that's a little bit more of a clicky than I wanted it to be.
I'm so scared to do this. It's gonna go, it's fine. Make sure I get my mustache. I'm gonna go in with a little paintbrush.
Next, we are going to go in with all the black. Black eyes, black nose, and black mouth. And we're going for a teardrop shape on the eyes. So I'm just gonna start by doing my lids first, and then we will do the outline for the top. Imagine making like a bunny on your nose. So that's how I always do like my pumpkin makeup or like a skeleton look, is start with a bunny on your nose and then reshape it or build it out. Switch brushes real quick. Drooling a little bit, I don't know why. Alright, and then we need to get started on the mouth. It's kind of like wonky. going to go ahead and make the teardrop eyes. A little creepy. Okay, now that I have my eyes, my nose, and the outline for the mouth, I'm gonna start filling in my mouth. Thank you. So, if you plan on doing a pumpkin face, literally you can do the line detail on the pumpkin any which way you want. You can use a darker or lighter shade of orange, you can do black lines, you can do yellow, green, what have you. When I did my watermelon look for Summerween, I just used various lines and different shades of greens and yellows to make it look watermelon. So we're gonna start doing the line detailing on the pumpkin now. I am going to take the palette I used before and use the orange color and just start in. And you're gonna be building this, so it is absolutely okay if you can't really see it at first. Then next, I am going to go in with a yellow, I think, just for highlight and dimension. It'll bring out your lighter orange areas. Then we will go in with the black. Use the black very sparingly and carefully. Just because, I mean, if you're doing the way that I'm doing, You don't want it to be like super dark, solidified lines. It's just giving it a little bit more detail by me doing it this way. And the main reason why I do eyeshadow when I do my pumpkin details is because I can just blend it out. It is also handy because I don't do perfectly straight lines whatsoever. So to kind of correct that, I blend it out. I don't want to do this. Okay, we're doing it. Not done yet. Some final touches. We're gonna do the little squigglies. Very lightly. Thank you. I am going to put on some lashes and mascara. I'll be right. This is the final look, featuring my horrible wig, but it was giving Vine, so I thought I'd just throw it on. And you know what? I'm not an eyelash girl. Ooh. That's it, I'm not going. I am JC. Always like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next weekend. Thank you.